Danny Lee. I believe I have a reservation here.
Okay. I'm sorry, Mr. Lee, but according to our computer, you aren't scheduled to arrive until the day after tomorrow, on the 5th.
The 5th?
That's what our computer indicates. Unfortunately, this is convention week in the city, and we don't have any spare rooms. But I'm sure I could locate something for you in the interim. Shall I find you other accommodations, Mr. Lee?
No, that would not be necessary. I will get my own.
Hello? No, the reception is at the Purple Dragon.
Ask for Lin Wo, he'll tell you where to put the cake.
Okay, thanks, bye. Oh, slack shirts and socks, right, guys?
Right. Lucy, what are you doing here?
Yeah, it must be a pretty tough place they're running here if they make you work on your wedding day.
I thought nobody was supposed to see the bride today.
Oh, it's just everything's gotten a little crazy. The shop's a good place to hide in for a while.
Can you hang your socks?
Oh, yeah. Lucy does that especially for me. You see, I can't stand the way that the elastic at the top gets all stretched out when you put them in a little ball. So I bring them here, and she washes them and hangs them for me. Isn't that nice how they come out? Nice and straight.
I never met anybody that hung their socks.
Very common.
Hey, guys. Lucy, I got a feeling this is not a case of wedding day jitters, is it?
It's my Aunt Kay and her cousin Danny Lee.
What, are they seated at the reception together and they hate each other, right?
Oh, I wish it were just that. No. Danny Lee was supposed to come in yesterday for the wedding, but that's all that showed up.
What, his luggage?
That's right. His suitcase has made it, but cousin Danny didn't. We haven't heard a thing from him. The police don't have a thing to go on. They haven't received any reports with someone of his description. It's like he just disappeared.
Where did he come in from?
Peking. He's a university professor in history. He flew into San Francisco and was supposed to make a connecting flight to Los Angeles, but he never made the transfer.
Well, Lucy, is it possible that he missed his flight from China and just hasn't been able to get in touch with you yet?
No, we know he made it to San Francisco. The airline confirmed that he was on that flight. Besides, Danny Lee is an American citizen. He speaks perfect English. Aunt Kay is beside herself. She's letting her imagination run wild. She was so excited because the family hasn't seen Danny Lee in about 10 years. I want to do everything I can to help her, but I've just got so much on my mind right now.
Look, if it's okay, could we take a look through the luggage? We may run across something, you never know.
No, please, go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello? What do you mean the Purple Dragon doesn't know about the reception? Did you talk to Lin Wo? Look, just wait there. I'll be right over in a few minutes. Look, guys, I gotta take off. If you guys want to stay here and look through the suitcases, just lock the door and put the clothes sign out.
Oh, there's something. Right.
What is it?
I don't know, Marie. It's got Chinese writing on it, though.
Oh, it's a tourist map of San Francisco. Look at all the places he planned to go. Well, he had an interesting schedule plan, that's for sure.
This is really strange. I don't recall Danny saying anything about visiting San Francisco.
You know, maybe his luggage got mixed up and, got put on the wrong flight or something. Say, Lucy, can you make it out here?
Their addresses and dates, like this one, it says 42 Embarcadero at 9 p.m. on the 5th.
5th? That'd be tomorrow.
Well, that might explain why he's not here. Maybe he had to go to that address earlier than he'd planned.
It was kind of strange. He wouldn't call and let you know.
This is all so ominous. I mean, why would Danny be going to any of these places? We don't have any relatives in San Francisco. Why did this have to happen on my wedding day?
All right.
Well, let's just go find him, guys.
What?
Well, you know, I could start by running some computer checks. Then if that doesn't turn up anything, we could check these addresses here. Maybe we'll find Danny Lee at one of them, huh? Having a meal or something.
You mean go all the way to San Francisco? You can't do that.
What's a piece of cake? And then meet me, what? It's only, what, three hours?
Yeah, I was kind of hoping to get out of town anyway.
Well, I really appreciate it, guys. I do, but I really can't afford to hire private detectives right now.
Well, then consider it a wedding gift from the three of us.
Yeah, I'll return the crock pot.
And from now on, we get free starch in our underwear.
Hey,
free.
Listen, if you guys figure this one out, you will get free dry cleaning for the rest of your life.
There's nothing. There's not one listing.
Well, what's up? What's the matter?
Well, I ran a preliminary check on every medical facility in the Bay Area, even the morgues, and none of them has had a Danny Lee registered over the past 2 days. So whatever detained him in San Francisco, it wasn't an accident or something that might have put him in the hospital.
Well, listen, Murray, we got those addresses. Maybe something will turn up. Who knows? Maybe he got the whole schedule screwed up and he's staying in a hotel somewhere.
Hey, if he's in a hotel, he either locked out or he booked it 3 months ago. This woman I just talked to says there's a convention in town. There's not a hotel room to be had.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Wait a minute. I can't believe I didn't think of this. I should have thought of this right away. It's
what?
So obvious.
What? Right. What?
Jerome Sedgwick.
Jerome Sedgwick? How could you let a name like that slip your mind?
It's unconscionable. Who's Jerome Sedgwick?
Jerome Sedgwick, I told you about him. He's a friend of mine from MIT. He teaches nuclear physics up at Stanford. Boy, he is a really great guy. You're gonna love him. He's got a great sense of humor.
Murray, what about Jerome? What does he do, blow up hotels on the side or something, or what?
He's got a boat up in the San Francisco Marina, I know that. As a matter of fact, he's been trying to get me up there for years. I'm sure he'd just love to put us up. I'm gonna call him.
Murray, yeah. Murray.
What?
I don't think it's a great idea to impose ourselves on this Jerome guy on such short notice. You know,
Don't be ridiculous. He's going to love it, and he's going to love you guys, too. I mean, he's a real funster. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello? Yeah, I'm trying to reach Jerome Sedgwick. Yeah. Oh, good, yeah. Tell him that that Bebop Baczynski's calling.
Bebop Baczynski?
He's a funster.
I mean, some of these places aren't exactly tourist traps, you know? Warehouses, alleys, docks.
Sure has that drug deal kind of ring to it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
You don't think that Danny Lee would be doing something illegal, do you? I mean, after all, he's a history professor. He's a man of learning.
Murray, we're just speculating here, okay?
Look, would someone mind speculating where this heliport is supposed to be, please?
Gee, Nick, I have absolutely no idea. I mean, all Jerome said was to head for the Bay Bridge, and we couldn't miss it.
Wait a minute, Nick. I think I see what Murray's talking about. Look down there.
Oh, look at that. It says, Welcome, Bebop. And Jerome, he painted a sign.
Is he a card?
Hey, guys, look at the car that Jerome sent for us. Oh, wow. Oh, man, he really, you know, he takes care of his... Look at the champagne. Hey, he sent some champagne, too. It's my favorite year, too. Oh, he is something. There's a note. Look at this. Hey, Bebop.
Sorry I couldn't meet you in person. The keys are in the ignition, Bebop. And there's a map to my boat in the glove compartment. Bring your dancing shoes, signed Roman Jerome. Gosh, I'll tell you, he's a great guy. You know, once when we were in MIT...
Listen, Murray, what do you say? We get the luggage in the trunk, okay, Murray?
Yeah. Come on. Oh, all right. I want to get it because I really want to get over there. I can't wait to see...
Surprised to hear about these nicknames you had for each other, you know?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that doesn't sound like your style.
Roman Jerome and Bebop. And like,
yeah, you guys must have had some wild times back at MIT,
right? Yeah. As a matter of fact, it was kind of wild. I guess I shouldn't tell you about it.
Okay.
No, well, I'll tell you, because you're really going to love it. You see, this is great. The way that I got my nickname, you see, I used to have this gyroscopic oscillator and had a loose wire on it. Every time I used it, it would go, beep-bop, beep-bop, beep. Oh, it was hysterical. You see, Jerome, he got his nickname because of a faulty electron microscope, if you can imagine that. You see, every time he would isolate a specimen, the stage would start to wiggle around, and he'd have to go roaming for it. You get it? Roaming? Can you imagine roaming around for protons? I mean, it was a scream.
Well, you had to ask.
So I walk into the lab, all set to give electron isotopes, and what do I find? Helium balloons and a cake decorated with a periodic chart. Those sons of guns students of mine are throwing me a surprise birthday party. Isn't that just rich?
Your favorite, Professor Dr. Sedgwick.
Yeah. I tell you, nitpicky problems aside, teaching is one darn rewarding profession. Yeah.
I don't believe it! Bebop!
Hey, Roman!
Hey. You old computer jock, you!
Minus one!
Minus one! I can't believe it! Bebop!
I can't believe it either.
How long's it been?
Too long.
It's been a long time, yeah. Bebop. Yep. Yeah.
This ought to be an easy conversation to jump right into.
Oh, I'm really sorry, guys. Yeah, come on. I completely forgot I haven't seen my friend Jerome in so... How many years?
It's been 8 years.
10, I think.
It's been 10 years.
It's been 10 years.
It's been a long time.
But listen, I'd like to introduce you to my dear friend Jerome Sedgwick. These are also my dear friends, Nick Ryder and Cody Allen.
Hi, Jerome.
How are you, Jerome?
Nice. I've heard a lot about you.
Oh, yeah? Say knock, knock.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
I completely forgot about the knock-knock. She's got thousands of them.
Thousands of them.
Yeah, thousands.
I got a feeling we're going to hear every one of them.
So, what is the story, Murray? You're here on business or something?
Yeah, actually, that's right, Jerome. We're on a case, which in the language of the trade means we're on assignment currently prescribed to us by a specific client, you see. And this case happens to be an old friend of ours. She's a very sweet girl, too. Yesterday was her wedding day, and of all days, she finds out that one of her guests, her cousin, happens to be missing. So we came up here to see if we could find out what happened to him, you know?
Look, Jerome, why don't you show us where we're going to be staying? That way we can get our stuff.
Right, I'm sorry. Inge Elke, come here a minute. I want you to meet a couple of friends of mine. Inge Bjornback and her sister Elke. I'd like you to meet Nick and Murray and Cody.
Very nice to meet you.
Come here a minute. I want you to meet some people.
Oh.
Inge and Elke are students of orthopedic therapy. They give a hell of a back rub. They're also like my hostesses.
Yeah.
So if you ever need anything, just call on them. They know this tub like the back of their hand, and they sure do see
the back of their hand. Look, Jerome, could you just show us where we're going to be staying?
Oh, sure. Walk this way.
This
It's right down here. There are a couple of steps.
All right. Cody?
Janet?
Oh, you two know each other. See, Janet, I told you to have a good time at my party.
Yes, you did, Jerome. Hi, Nick. It's nice to see you again.
Same here, Janet.
Well, I seem to be the wandering proton again. My name is Murray Buczynski.
I'm sorry, Murray. This is an old friend of mine from college, Janet Ingram.
Yes, I'm pleased to meet you.
It's a pleasure to meet you. I've certainly seen you on enough magazine covers.
Oh, well, you know.
Well, Janet is the press secretary for the liaison division on Capitol Hill. She's kind of a big shot herself.
Oh, the liaison? Well, what brings you to San Francisco?
Business, pleasure, and lots of meetings.
I tell you what, why don't we get it squared away in our cabins and we can talk later?
You guys go on ahead. I'll be with you in a minute.
Yeah, right.
Okay, well, it was nice to meet you. I hope we get to talk.
Murray, let's go on downstairs to what's
talk soon, yeah.
It's been a long time.
7.5 years.
Buy me a drink?
Look, since I knew that you'd be working while you were here, I took the liberty of getting together a couple of things for your convenience. I hope it's satisfactory.
Oh, Jerome, buddy, if it's satisfactory to you, I'm sure that... Satisfactory? What, are you kidding me? This is great. This is fantastic. I feel like I'm at home.
Well, that's the idea. Look, we have one rule around here, and that is this. Everyone has to have fun or they get thrown overboard. Look, if you need anything, just ask me, the girls.
Our room is right next door.
Yeah, look, Jerome, this is really great. Look, we're just going to get started on the case, okay? So going up to the party. Don't let us hold you up.
Okie dokie. If you need me, I'll be upstairs. Shaking my booty. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Orange.
Orange who?
Orange, you're glad it's not banana again. All right, we're out of here. We're history.
He's a funny guy.
He's something, Murray. Look, why don't you punch into one of these computers and see if you can find what hotel Danny Lee's registered in, all right?
Yeah, that's a great idea, Nick. Listen, should we go get Cody? Because I'm sure he'd love to see this equipment.
No, I think we can do this without him. I think everything's all right.
Oh, yeah, everything must be all right. I mean, judging from the look of that friend of his, she's something, isn't she?
Yeah, she's something else.
Yeah.
Listen, what are you getting? What's going on?
Oh, well, I didn't get anything yet, but I've just programmed in the search. Say, listen, you know, I know that this is probably none of my business, but judging from the look on Janet and Cody's face when they saw each other, you don't think they used to date or something, do you?
Look, Murray, it's a long story, okay? Let's not go into it. Let's just see what we can find here, okay?
Oh, yeah, sure, all sure. Right. It was none of my business anyway.
So after trying out a couple of different things, Nick and I finally decided to bring Murray into it and open up our own detective agency. So far, it's worked out pretty well.
It's great. I must say, though, I'm a little surprised. I have a hard time picturing you in a high-rise building with a bunch of secretaries and intercoms.
I have a pretty hard time imagining it, too. Especially since we work out of my boat where we live, and the closest thing to a secretary we've got is this orange robot that Murray designed.
Ah, yeah. Well, that's the Cody Allen I knew in college.
Is the weather still bad in Washington?
Have we already run out of things to say?
No, there's plenty more to talk about. I just feel a lot safer with the weather, that's all.
Ah, there you are. We've been looking all over for you.
Oh, is it time to go back to the hotel already?
I'm afraid so. Yeah, they pushed the meeting up to 4 o'clock, so I'm sorry to break this up.
That's right. I understand. Janet and I are just old friends.
Oh, I'm sorry, Cody Allen. This is Roger Dorquette and Mark Eastman. They're colleagues of mine.
How are you?
How do you do?
Hi. Old friends, huh? Well, I'm glad to hear that. Janet's always yelling at us about busting up potential dates.
Yeah, but we also rescued her from a lot of real losers, too. I mean, don't forget about that.
Well, this time you've done neither. So we're even, guys.
Well, I guess we lucked out this time, Roger.
Yeah, thank goodness.
So what?
Nice to meet you, Cody.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, Cody? Cody, oh, there you are. Listen, this is great. Yeah, Nick had me tap into all the hotels in the city, and when I did, I found out that Danny Lee was scheduled to check into the Holiday Inn today, but he hasn't shown up yet.
Oh, yeah, Murray, that's great. At least we know he had definite plans to stay here.
Yeah, look, I left a message at the front desk for him to call us if he ever shows up. Look what I did. In the meantime, what I did is I had Murray make up one of those computerized pictures, right, of Danny Lee based off the photo that Lucy gave us.
With all the equipment that Jerome put in our room there, I didn't have to bring anything up.
See, the way I figured, there's enough conventions in town that someone ought to recognize them if we tack these up in enough places.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Mm-hmm. Say, where's Janet? Did you two guys have a good time talking?
Yeah, we did, Murray. We had a good time. She had to go to a meeting.
Oh, gee, that's too bad. I was kind of looking forward to talking to her about Washington, you know?
Yeah, me too.
Well, maybe some other time.
You guys gonna get together later?
No, I doubt it. Listen, we got a couple hours before we start checking out that other address. Let's put these posters up, huh? Yeah.
Hello. Look, you guys get me a seat down near the front, okay? I'm going to pick up my banquet tickets, all right?
Right. Go.
Hi. My name is Parker, Dean Parker. I want to pick up my banquet tickets.
If we don't hurry up, we're liable to miss intercepting Danny Lee.
I'll tell you something, I think Lucy was right to worry about Cousin Danny. You don't exactly come down here at this hour to take tourist photos.
Yeah?
I'm looking for the foreman about passage on a freighter.
The only freighter available is the China Wall. Will that do? Yvonne, please.
Well, this place is spooky.
Back, you cover the front.
Got it?
Okay. All right.
Nothing. What about the guy who fired at us? Did you get a look at him?
No, I couldn't make out a thing.
Hey, guys! He was dead when I found him.
All right, you three, your hands up. Up against the wall. Come on now, spread them.
This is an outrage. I mean, first we're held for questioning by the cops, right? Then they drag us over here to the feds where we answer the same questions. I mean, we have been here all night. Murray. This is ridiculous.
Murray, take it easy now. Look, we've obviously just stumbled onto something touchy here.
That's an understatement.
When's the last time you saw this much attention being given to a dock worker's murder?
Makes you wonder who the dock worker was, huh?
Better yet, who murdered him?
Well, be that as it may, I hope whoever it is who's been scrutinizing us for the past 8 hours has figured it out, because I, for one, am sick and tired of being treated like a caged animal.
I know this guy. Where have I seen him before?
His name's Murray Buzinski. You've probably seen him on the cover of Science Magazine.
Oh, yeah, yeah, the whiz kid of computer games and stuff.
Right. The other two are Nick Ryder and Cody Allen, both veterans. Now the three of them run the Riptide Detective Agency out of King Harbor, California. They claim to be up here working on a case, and that they were following up a lead at the warehouse last night when they found the body.
Wait a minute, Cody Allen.
Yeah, Cody Allen, that's the guy that Janet introduced us to at Cedric's party yesterday. Remember, Roger, the old friend?
Yes, we did.
Hello. Yes, he is. Hold on. Mr. Eastman. It's for you.
Yeah, this is Eastman.
This is the China Wall.
Where are you, China Wall?
After last night, that will be the information I give to no one.
What happened?
I think that is something you should be explaining to me. I arrived in time to see my contact being removed in a body bag.
We don't know what went wrong, but we're investigating it right now. Proceed as scheduled.
I will proceed according to my own schedule. If you want the information, you will do as I say now.
What about the rendezvous?
I will be in touch. From now on, I make the rules, and I call the shots.
Where is he? Can we bring him in?
No, he's spooked. He won't even give me his location.
We can give him protection, otherwise he's just out there on the loose.
I know that. There's nothing I can do until he calls in again. All right, for the time being, let's just keep an eye out on our three out-of-towners.
Let's keep an eye out on Janet, too, just to be sure.
It's about time. I was beginning to think you were going to let us rot in that
room. Out. Everything's fine.
It's ridiculous.
Well,
I mean,
you got to argue with the guy.
He didn't offer an explanation as to what. We have civil liberties, you know. I think it's ridiculous that we...
Murray!
Jerome, did you get my message?
Huh? Well, yes and no. Ingi must have misunderstood. She thought you said you were arresting. Instead of that, you were arrested. When I finally figured it out this morning, I called up Janet in case you needed some extra clout. You know, government girl.
Yeah, that's very, very smart, Jerome. Good thinking. Hi there, Janet. It's good to see you again.
You too, Murray.
Is there anything I can do for you, Murray? I am so sorry it took this long to get
it. Look, don't worry about it, Jerome. These things happen, right? I mean, they happen.
Look, Jerome, we got everything worked out, okay? Thanks for your help. Yours too, Janet.
Oh, all I did was drive down here. But you're welcome anyway. Well, I really better be going.
Janet?
I was just wondering if you'd want to spend some time today with me.
Actually, I'm pretty busy. Maybe later.
Well, Janet, wait. I want us to be friends.
Well, I'm just going to do some sightseeing if you'd like to join me.
I'd love to. Just give me a minute. What do we have to do today in terms of the case?
Well, let me see. I'd like to check that address out tonight, but other than that, I can't think of anything.
Well, I'd like to find out what went on last night and why they kept us here. You see, I think Danny Lee's involved in this somehow.
Yeah, but we were in there all night long and they didn't tell us anything.
Well, Murray, look, that's easy. All we got to do is go out and find out ourselves, that's all.
Yeah, I haven't seen Janet for a long time. You know, I'd just like to spend some time with her. Can you guys spare me for a while?
Oh, sure, yeah. I think we can spring you for a couple hours.
Sure, no problem.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks. Yeah. Thanks.
Have a good time.
Okay.
You know, I really think it's great that they're going to spend some time together.
Yeah. And this is the time to do it, too, because after she accepts her new appointment, it'll be tough just getting on her calendar.
What appointment?
The London Bureau. She's been asked to head up the entire press office for the liaison division. It's quite a move upward.
Wow, that's quite an opportunity. Don't you think that's a great opportunity, Nick?
Yeah, no, I think that's great. Listen, why don't we go see if we can find Danny Lee, all right?
It's even more wonderful than I imagined.
Yeah? You've never been in San Francisco before?
No, I never made it here.
Well, how do you know Jerome?
I think I first met Jerome about 2 years ago in Washington when he was giving a presentation on nuclear energy.
Nuclear energy, really?
Yeah.
I bet he started with a knock-knock joke.
I think he did.
I figured. I think this is the second time I've been here. First time really doesn't count. I was drunk all the time.
Ah, that sounds like a college spring break if I ever heard one.
No, it wasn't a spring break, actually. It was the week I shipped out to Nam. We left from Oakland.
I was really surprised when I'd heard that you quit school to join the Army.
Yeah, I guess it surprised a lot of people. It seemed like a good idea at the time.
Do you regret your decision?
I don't regret anything anymore. I learned a long time ago it does make a damn bit of difference. Give me your camera. Yeah. Take a picture of you with the bridge in the back.
No, no. Let's get one of us together.
How are we gonna do that?
Why don't you ask that guy over there?
Excuse me. Would you take a picture of the two of us?
Sure. Why not?
Thanks.
You're welcome.
According to the visa information, Danny Lee is a professor of history from the University of Peking. He's in good standing. I mean, there's absolutely nothing here that would indicate why the United States government should have the least bit of interest in him.
Okay. Man's been out of the country for 10 years, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's go back. Let's go back to 1970, all right, and see if anything turns up. Try that.
Okay, but this is really getting frustrating.
I know, Mark.
I mean, I feel like the time is just slipping through our fingers here, and we haven't come up with any clues, just dead bodies.
Is your muscle sore? We can cure neck.
Yeah.
Oh, well,
No, I'm fine. Thank you, I'm all right.
Oh, this feels wonderful, Nick.
Murray, try to work the computer in between strokes, all right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Attention units 24 and 25, 927 Denver, possible dead body in the city dump. Unit 24 handle, 25 assist.
Did you hear that, Murray?
Hear what?
That police scanner report. Somebody called in a dead body found at the city dump.
That's horrible.
Yeah, if we can get down there, maybe we can find out what happened.
Why would we possibly care?
Murray, look, ladies, excuse me. Murray, we care because we're trying to find someone who's missing, okay? Now, give me a break. We got to get down there and check this thing out, right?
No, we have to walk on Dr. Murray's back with our feet
look,
first.
Look, ladies, the walk's going to have to wait till later, okay? Come on, Murray,
no,
let's
go. No, but they got
to
walk on my
feet. Walk later. Come on.
No, wait a minute. Hey, wait. What happens if Cody comes back and we're not here, huh?
Murray, I doubt he's going to come back, all right? Leave him a note. Tell him we're checking out Alina. I'm going to wait for you outside.
Okay.
Now, hurry up.
I'm leaving a note. I'm going to leave a note. Shoulders feel great. I mean, I think it's incredible what Inga and Elka can do with their fingers, you know?
I'm sure you're not the first man to say that, Murray.
Well, you know, you and Cody would be wise to let them give you a massage as well, because it's just incredible.
I don't think Cody's gonna have much time for Inga and Elka.
Oh, yeah. Say, Nick, correct me if I'm wrong about this, but I get the feeling that you don't approve of Cody spending any time with Janet.
Oh, no, Murray. It's not for me to approve or disapprove.
Well, he's a big boy. He can take care of himself. I just don't want to see him get hurt, that's all.
Well, see, that's what I don't understand, Nick, because he seems to be very happy with Janet.
Well, I don't think happy is the word. He's in love with her, I know that much.
In love? How in the world could he be in love with her? I haven't heard him say two words about this girl before. I thought they were just old college friends.
Oh, they are. They used to live together in college.
Oh, so they were very serious, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, was there talk of them getting married?
Sure was. Except Janet graduated before Cody and took a job in Washington, D.C. He never said anything to me about it, but I think that's one of the main reasons why he quit college.
So is this the first time they've seen each other since?
No. About 8 years ago, we ran into her in Washington while we were on furlough. Cody and I hadn't been friends very long, but I knew him well enough to know that he hadn't gotten her out of his system yet. After we left, I watched him go through hell. I just don't want to see him go through that again after we leave San Francisco, that's all.
Restricted area, you'll have to stay behind the line.
I understand that. Listen, I was just wondering if you could tell me who the victim is.
We don't have a positive ID yet. Why? Do you know something about this?
Well, my name is Nick Ryder. This is Murray Buzinski. We're private detectives from Los Angeles. Now, we're looking for a guy who's been missing for about 3 days. Chinese man by the name of Danny Lee. Got a picture right here. Is this the man you found by any chance?
Well, the guy we've got is Asian, but it would be hard to identify him from this picture. We can let you take a look, but I gotta warn you, though. It's pretty grim. He's been buried in all that junk a day or so.
Yeah, well, let's take a look.
Hey, Chuck, you wanna have him bring the body over here? We've got a guy who might be able to ID him. This watch was found on the victim. Do you recognize it?
My face is cracked.
Yeah, it must have happened in the struggle. Whoever murdered him cut off his left hand.
Well, that's horrible.
Told you it was grim. Took a 9mm through the neck. Is this the man you're looking for?
I don't know. It's a little hard to tell. My client could do it. It's gonna take me a couple days to get her up here, though. She's on a honeymoon right now.
All right. Just let me know. My name's Sergeant Tuttle.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Are you all right?
I've seen dead bodies before. But this time, I'm thinking it might be Danny Lee. I mean, how do we tell Lucy something like that? How do we ask her to come up here and look at that and tell us whether or not it was her cousin?
I don't know, Murray. I really don't know.
What is it? Something wrong?
Hang on, Murray. I'm gonna take you for a quick tour of San Francisco.
Now.
Yeah. head.
Hold it, hold it. Mr. Ryder, take it easy now. Easy does it. Easy. Federal Agent Webb. Now, look, we can discuss all this when you come with me.
This is Eastman.
This is Torres. Yeah, I lost the man and the woman. We got tangled up on a traffic jam on the bridge, and they got away from me.
It's okay. I got the other two with me right now, so just come on in and call it a day.
Dick! Burry? Listen, I'm sorry I'm late. There was a lot of traffic on
the... I understand that. Where would they be? Maybe they went to the other address.
Oh, Cody.
Hmm?
I think they left a note.
Yeah.
Yeah, they went to check out a lead, but they didn't say what time they left. Maybe we should just meet them at the other address.
Yeah, we could do that. I don't think you should go, though. We found a dead body last night.
What could be worse than a dead body? I'll be fine. Now, where is this place?
It's the Exploratorium.
Might have been Nick.
Nick? Nick?
I'm gonna check this out. You wait in the car.
Are you crazy? You've got the gun. I'm coming with you.
Doing here?
Take it easy. Sorry to startle you, sir. My name is Cody Allen. I'm a private investigator. I was here to meet my partners.
Well, there's nobody here but me, and I've been here the better part of the evening. This ain't exactly the best spot in town to be hanging out with a woman, you know.
Yeah, I can see that. Okay, we're taking off. I'm sorry.
Is this Inga?
Inga, listen, this is Cody Allen. Are Nick and Murray there?
No. No Nick and Murray.
Have they called looking for me by any chance?
No Nick, Murray, just Dean Parker.
Who?
Dean Parker. Cody, you come back to boat. We have a wonderful party here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure you do, Inga. Thank you very much. I'll talk to you later.
Well, if they left any messages and not at the desk. Are they back at the boat yet, by any chance?
I don't think so, but I was talking to Inga, so it's impossible to say where they are. All she could tell me was that a guy named Dean Parker called. Probably wants a massage.
Well, listen, we don't know what time they left the note, so maybe they're still following the lead.
I don't know. I should never let them go off without me, you know? I mean, I just let myself keep... I should have known better, that's all.
Cody, I know that you're concerned, but they're adults. I'm sure that they're capable of taking care of themselves.
Janet, that's not the point. The point is I'm a professional, I'm their partner, I owe it to them to contribute my fair share of the casework.
They're also your friends. I think they'd understand.
Look,
I'm sure that you've carried the ball for them on occasion. We all have to let our job take a back seat once in a while.
Oh, that's a really interesting point coming from you.
What?
Nothing. Forget it.
No. You just insinuated that I never let my job take a back seat. Okay. No, I want to know why you said that.
I'm tired. I'm worried about Nick and Murray, okay? Just forget it.
Fine. Okay, sure. Yeah, I'll pretend you didn't say that. Along with all the other insinuations you've been making since we ran into each other.
Let's not get into it, okay? It was a beautiful day. I'd like to remember it.
Oh, heaven knows how. I mean, after spending it with the one woman who you still hold responsible for ruining your life.
I think you're giving yourself a little too much credit.
Oh, really? Wasn't I the one who threw you over to selfishly pursue my own ambitious goals?
Yes, as a matter of fact, you are the one who did that. You're also the one who told me that you loved me more than anything in the world. Until a career opportunity came along, then you left me. You know, I could understand that if you'd left me for another man. It's a little hard on the ego when the woman you love leaves you for a desk job.
I was 24 years old, and you weren't out of college yet. If we'd gotten married then, it would have been disastrous.
Unlike it is now, with both of us getting along so harmoniously.
Okay, fine. I take the blame for that one. But you're the one who never answered my letters after
the start. Why should I? What was the point? I didn't see the point.
No! You wanted to get back at me.
I didn't.
And you still do.
I didn't want to get back.
Today you told me you wanted us to be friends.
We can't be friends. We can never be friends. I realized that today. Hell, I realized that yesterday when I saw you on the boat. We can't be friends, not until I fall out of love with you, and I pray to God that happens soon.
What time is it?
1971.
What?
Feels like 1971, doesn't it? Like nothing's changed. Mm. Well, like we've never been apart.
We certainly fight the same, don't we?
Haven't lost any of our steam, have we?
No, we haven't. We even make up the same. Hello. Yes, this is Miss Ingram. Oh, I'm fine, Mr. Vice President. No, you're not interrupting anything. I was just reading the morning papers. They're not in their rooms? Well, we have a preliminary meeting at 9:30. Is there anything you'd like me to tell them? Yes, I will. Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.
The man has lousy timers.
Well, he couldn't find Roger or Mark in their room, so he called me.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Don't blame. That's probably them. Who is that?
It's Nick. Is Cody there?
Could you hand me my robe?
Yeah.
Yeah, Nick!
Yeah.
Hang on.
Yeah, come on in, you guys. I was wondering what happened to you.
Yeah, we were wondering about you, too. We would have called, but you'd be surprised how uncooperative the guys down at the liaison division can be these days.
Liaison what? Division?
Yeah, it seems that we spent the night there with two of your colleagues, Janet. Dorquette and Eastman.
You know, this is all getting pretty old. I've been in San Francisco for 2 days now. I haven't had one night's sleep, and I keep winding up in government offices.
Why would the liaison division be interested in you guys?
Well, that's a good question, Cody. They followed us all day, and we were driving around. Nick tried to lose them, but they brought us in anyway.
Of course, they probably didn't have to tell you guys because they had an inside woman on the job.
I don't know anything about this. I'm sorry that you were put through all that trouble, but I had nothing to do with it. What did they want?
Well, actually, Cody, it had to do with Danny Lee. I think we might have found him.
Danny Lee?
Do you know him?
I know the name. What do you have to do with Danny Lee?
Well, he's the reason we're in San Francisco. He's the man we're looking for. Where is he?
Look, why don't we get out of Janet's way here, and Murray and I'll explain everything to you, all right?
Yeah, fine. I'll just go wash up.
Okay, we'll wait for you in the lobby.
I'm sorry to bother you and everything.
No, it's okay, Murray. You're both welcome to stay if you'd like.
No, thanks.
You afraid I'll take Cody away from you again?
No, Janet. I'm not afraid if you take Cody from us. Just do me a favor this time. Keep him for good, all right? Don't punch all of his buttons, send him into a tailspin, and throw him out again. Don't do that.
Is that what you think I do to him?
No, I'm just telling you that every time a guy gets within 100 miles of you, his life goes upside down on him. He's my best friend, okay? It's gonna hurt like hell to have to help him pick up the pieces again.
Well, at least he had you to help him. So far, I've done it alone.
I doubt that.
Listen, Nick, why don't we wait downstairs?
Look, Nick, I'm tired of being the bad guy in this scenario. What's your problem? You don't even know me well enough to hate me.
Janet, I don't hate you. I just don't have a whole lot of admiration for the way you waltz in and out of Cody's life every so often, that's all.
Is that the picture he's painted of us?
Actually, Janet, he's never said a thing. As a matter of fact, he's never even mentioned you.
Nick, I understand how you feel being a good friend of his. And I'd probably have the same feelings if I was in your shoes and didn't know the whole story. So I'll tell it to you straight. I've loved Cody ever since college, and I still love him. And the last thing I'm going to do is throw this away.
You try to remember that when you accept that appointment in London.
I missed something?
No, not at all. Janet and I are just getting to know each other.
See you later.
Good luck.
So
anyway, when Nick saw this car tailing us, Cody, he tried cornering it, and that's when we discovered that the guy driving it was part of this liaison division. And that's how we wound up there all night. But the interesting thing is that Danny Lee is apparently a very important person to them, and we just sort of stumbled on all this.
I don't know. There's something real big going down in the city with those friends of Janet's. They're not here on a public relations gig, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, I agree with you, Nick.
All right, so where do we stand with Danny Lee? Do you really think that was his body they found in the dump?
I hope not.
Well, it's hard to tell because of the shape he was in, but I think it was.
Well, I guess we'll know as soon as we can get Lucy up here or one of her family members to identify him.
And that's one phone call I'm not looking forward to making.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Well, what about the government, the liaison division? If this guy's so important, why can't they ID him?
You know something? I got the impression these guys didn't even know what he looked like.
What are you talking about? That doesn't make any sense.
Look, Cody, think about this. Danny Lee flies in from Peking, right? He's supposed to be going to a wedding. Yeah. Now, none of his relatives know about this little side trip to San Francisco where he's scheduled to make a lot of very strange stops before meeting with government officials. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that smacks of every spy novel I've ever read in my life.
Spy? You think that Danny Lee is a spy?
I know it sounds weird. I mean, the whole story's weird. Why not make him a spy?
Yeah, coming in from the cold.
Now, that would explain why they can't ID him. They would never have seen this guy. He would just be a code word to them.
Well, how can we find out if this is true? How can we confirm this?
Well, we can't. Not without a source, at least.
We got a source. What about Janet?
No, absolutely not.
Why not? She'd help us if she knew what was going on.
Look, Cody, I just don't think you should drag her into the middle of this.
You can't drag her into anything. She can say no if she wants to.
All right. Do what you want.
Hey, you guys. Wait a minute, will you? Listen, I want to apologize for not being there for you yesterday. Jen and I got caught in a traffic jam on the Golden Gate Bridge. You know, we couldn't get through. Then we even went to the second address on Danny Lee's schedule, but obviously you weren't there. The point is, I'm sorry.
No, it's all right, Cody. We understand.
Don't worry about it. It's all right.
Thanks.
Did you have a good time?
Great.
That's all that's important.
All right, let's get back to business. I'll go run the machine down.
Okay. You gonna tell him about Janet's London appointment?
I don't know, Murray. I don't know what's gonna hurt him more. If it comes from me or if it comes from her, I don't know.
Well, of course, I don't know as much about these kind of things as you guys do. You know, this dealing with women and everything. But you wanna know what I think?
What?
Well, I think that sometimes things happen in our lives that hurt us. But if we try to keep these things from happening, we're only gonna make them worse. Now, I know Cody is our friend, and the last thing in the world we wanna see is him getting hurt. But I don't know if it's our place to jump in. I think as long as we have faith in him and believe in him and stay his friends, we're doing the best we can.
You know something, Murray? Sometimes I think you know more about some things than you think you do. You know that? Come on.
The Riptide Detective Agency? Oh, you mean those three party animals from King Harbor. Yeah, they are staying here, but they don't happen to be here at the...
Professor Sedgwick!
Wait a minute, I just lied. Here they are. It's a Dean Parker. He wants to talk to you about a poster.
Dean Parker? He's the one you said called, right, Dean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is Nick Ryder. Go ahead.
It's about the poster in the hotel here. I think I might have seen this man.
When was this?
Well, it's about 4 days ago when I first got into town at the airport in the men's room. And the reason that I noticed him is he had this fancy attaché case handcuffed to his left hand. You see, I'm a writer, thriller fiction to be exact. I'm up here in San Francisco at a thriller convention. I guess that's why I sort of have a nose for this kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, anyhow, after I saw him at the airport, lo and behold, I run into him right here in the hotel. Same briefcase and everything, only this time, the handcuff is off.
Mr. Parker, when was the last time you saw him at the hotel?
So later on the same afternoon, around 2:45, 3 o'clock.
Mr. Parker, look, I think we may have found this man's body. Now, I'll need someone to make a positive ID.
Well, I guess I can do that. I mean,
What the hey, experiencing the darker side of life is all part of writing too, anyhow, I guess, huh?
Yeah, I guess it is.
Listen, where are you and we'll pick you up?
No, I can't go now. I got a banquet in 20 minutes. Look, why don't you just pick me up at 9 o'clock, room 517, the Holiday Inn.
Okay, that's great. We'll pick you up at 9 o'clock.
Say, I wonder what's happened here.
I don't know. Let's just go find Parker.
All right. Oh, my goodness. This is terrible.
I can't believe it. One minute I'm standing there ready to give Dean his award. Next minute I'm standing over his dead body.
Excuse me, sir. I couldn't help but overhear what you just said.
Oh, you a friend of Dean's?
Gene Parker, was that?
He was such a great guy, you know? And a hell of a writer, too. A waste.
When did the accident occur?
Accident? It was no accident, mister. Somebody went into his room and killed him. He never even made it downstairs. Such a waste. Why did anybody want to kill Dean?
Yeah, and ever since we got here, all we've seen are police carrying off dead bodies.
So you don't think this is Danny Lee's work, do you?
Maria, I thought we were working on the assumption Danny Lee's dead. That's why we came to get Parker.
No, someone out there doesn't want us to know if Danny Lee's dead or not.
Yeah, but how would the killer, whoever it is, how would they know to come after Dean Parker? I mean, he's just some mystery writer at a convention.
Phone call.
What?
The phone call.
Phone call. That's right. I didn't even think of that.
Come on, Murray, we got to get back to Jerome.
What phone call? What are you talking about? Is Jerome in danger?
No, Murray.
What phone call? I can't believe this. It's a phone tap. Somebody tapped our phone. And that's how they knew that we were going to go see Dean Parker.
That would be my bet, Murray.
Yeah, but you know what I don't understand? That would mean that they would have to know what we were doing and where we were. Now, how could they figure that out?
It wouldn't be that hard. Our phone number's been plastered all over those posters.
And don't forget the government escort we've had all day. Don't forget that one.
Hey, you don't think that this special liaison division has anything to do with this, do you?
Well, there's one way to find out for sure.
First, I'd like to say that if anyone finds out that I've been talking to you about this, I could get arrested.
Janet, we don't want you to do anything you won't be comfortable with.
Janet, believe me, anything you tell us is safe with us. But we've got to know what's going on, because I got a feeling with this case we're heading for a brick wall full speed.
We've been working with a man inside the Chinese government for about 10 years. At first, we thought that it wasn't a crucial connection, and then we found out that he had access to information concerning China's progress in nuclear science. He's become invaluable to us.
And this man is Danny Lee, the history professor, right?
Yeah.
Well, you were right, Nick. Danny Lee is a spy.
The reason that we're meeting with him is to get information that he's collected and to give him the names of newly appointed contacts in China. That's a very delicate situation. He hasn't been in the country in over 10 years. So we've had to be extremely cautious about bringing him in. We set up a series of checkpoints before he contacted us. Unfortunately, things got screwed up early on.
So that body we found in the warehouse that first night, that was one of Danny Lee's checkpoints?
Yeah, the first one. There were two more to be made, but he stopped after he found the first contact dead.
Well, if Danny Lee is still at large, I wonder who that body was that they found at the dump.
Danny Lee.
What?
It's Danny Lee. The body at the dump is Danny Lee, just like we thought.
No, that's impossible. We've had contact with him since then.
No. And you've made contact with the wrong guy. Remember what Dean Parker said about running into a guy in the bathroom at the airport, and he had a briefcase handcuffed to his wrist. And about an hour later, you saw him at the hotel with the handcuff off.
Yeah, so?
Murray, the body at the dump had a severed left hand. Now, if you want to get something away from someone who's got a handcuff to his wrist, and you don't have a key, how do you do that?
Oh, my God, he cut it off.
That's right, you cut it off. But Dean also said he saw Danny at the hotel at 3 o'clock. The watch Danny was wearing was cracked at 1:30.
So that means that somebody killed Danny Lee between the airport bathroom and the hotel.
That's right.
Got the briefcase. and has been roaming around San Francisco as your spy.
I can't believe that. He would have had to have known every name, every connection, place, move. We have a very complex network to infiltrate. I can't believe that anyone could pull that off successfully.
You're right, no one can. But as good as this guy is, he overlooked one little detail. Yeah, his cousin's wedding in Los Angeles.
Which is why the luggage was forwarded.
Oh, my God.
All right, listen, all we have to do is contact your people. Contact Dorcat and Eastman and tell them what's going on. You could probably do that right away.
Roger and Mark are with him right now. They set up the meeting tonight. They're with him on Alcatraz Island.
Great, that's great. Murray, can Jerome get us a boat right away?
I don't see any reason why not.
Okay. Listen, try not to worry. We'll do everything we can. I'll get the car out of the lot. Meet me in front.
Nick.
Yeah?
I'm sorry about this afternoon.
It's all right. It's none of my business.
No, it is. You're Cody's best friend. And I think you had a right to say what you did. That's why I want you to know that I decided to turn down the appointment. I'm not going to London. I'm not even going back to Washington. I decided to give King Harbor a try.
Does Cody know about this?
Not yet.
No?
So you better make sure nothing happens before I get a chance to tell him.
You got my word. Welcome to the family.
They'd be meeting.
Oh, no, Murray. It'd have to be around here someplace.
Careful.
I don't think you could get in that prison. Of course, I don't know why you'd want to.
Watch your step.
Yeah. All right?
Yeah.
Eastman's got a pulse, but Dorcat's gone.
Oh, my God.
All right, can you get the number for me?
Hi. How you holding up?
Okay.
79? Okay. I got it. Thanks a lot.
Well, how do we stand?
Well, every port of entry is covered, but I don't think this guy's going to be leaving town in a commercial jet, so...
So all we can do is sit around and wait. Oh, I feel so ineffective just waiting.
Oh, listen, I just talked to one guy who said that special attention was being given to any satellite messages coming in from China. That means that if he tries to make contact with his people, maybe we can pinpoint his location.
Hey, guys, I've got it. Figured out who the imposter is.
Oh, great.
Well, we got a fingerprint off the phone tap, right? The liaison division has just confirmed that it's the thumbprint of a guy by the name of Mao Fei, who happens to be China's hottest covert operative. Apparently, the United States government has been trying to nail this guy for years.
Good, Murray. I wonder how much he found out from Eastman and Dorcat.
Oh, I've been so preoccupied with this spy business that I haven't even thought about them. I guess it hasn't really sunk in yet.
So where's Nick, anyway?
Lucy came into town tonight. He had to take her to the morgue to identify the body.
Listen, I better get over there, all right?
Hey, Janet, I'm having a hard time keeping the phone lines open here. I don't know how this stuff leaks out, but I've got newspapers from all over calling us. Can't you release some kind of statement, get these people off our damn backs?
Yeah, I'll get on it. I want you to put together as much up-to-date information as you can and circle anything that you don't want released. I'll put together some kind of a mini news conference.
Okay.
Here. Careful, it's kind of hot.
Danny's wedding present came in the mail today. It's a beautiful Chinese vase with inlaid doves, made out of mother of pearl. It's so delicate.
Lucy, I'm so sorry.
How am I going to tell my aunt about this? How am I going to tell her that her favorite cousin was killed by a foreign spy? She won't be able to understand any of this.
Lucy, you can be proud of your cousin. He was a very brave man who loved this country and served it well.
Kind of like a war hero who got killed in battle.
I thought about it that way for a while. I also thought about the way the rest of the world will read about this. Spies, imposters, secret information. It'll all be very interesting. Do you realize that real people with real families are involved? Until it affects your life. Until the person everyone is reading and talking about is someone you once knew. Someone who once gave you a dove face for your wedding. Please find the man who did this to my family.
The guy went in the fishing boat? Okay, get on board. If we're gonna make that run, better do it now. Sun's gonna be up pretty soon.
I need a wireless machine. Do you have one?
In the office. By the way, I get my money up front, 5,000, like we agreed.
We'll be back in a moment.
Murray, this is supposed to tell us something here?
Not in this form, Nick. You see, what the computer is doing is picking up transmissions in the airwaves and translating them into comprehensible messages. It's sort of like eavesdropping on every phone conversation in the city.
Sounds good to me. Where's Kevin?
I think he went into the press room, to bring Janet some hot coffee. She's been working through the night.
Oh, yeah?
Hello, Janet Ingram. Thank you. Oh, I have a press conference in an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Oh, I have to drink a pot of this stuff to stay awake at the podium.
Been a long day.
Yes, it has.
Listen, if it's this crazy for you in San Francisco, what's it like for you in Washington?
It can get pretty wild.
Do you think that a small-town PI could find happiness there?
What do you mean?
Well, since last night, I've been thinking a lot about us, and I want us to give it another try. Yes. In order to do that, we're going to have to be in the same city, right? So I figured I'd move to Washington.
Nick told you about London, didn't he?
About London? No, he didn't say anything about London. What about it?
I've been offered to head the London Bureau.
That's wonderful, Janet.
I'm turning it down. I even told Nick I was quitting my job so I could be here with you in California. I thought he told you. That's why you offered to come to Washington.
No, he didn't say anything about that. Janet, you can't quit your job, you know?
Of course I can. I've thought about what you said. And you're right. I've let my career lead my life, and it's led me away from the one man I've always loved.
Yeah, but Janet, look at all you've accomplished. I've watched you deal with this whole situation now. You,
You're not the young graduate student I knew 15 years ago. You're an executive now. You're good at fast-paced work. You can't move to a place like King Harbor. You go crazy there.
Well, what about you? You run a successful business. You can't throw that away.
Well,
besides, you'd hate Washington.
I get used to it. That's the point.
But why go to the trouble? I'm willing to come to you. This was a much happier moment in my fantasy.
Yeah. Well, that's what it is, a fantasy.
What?
Janet, look at us, will you? Will you look at us? We're right back to square one. How can two people who care so much about each other be so totally out of sync all the time?
It's a minor problem, Cody. I'm willing to come to you, and you're willing to come to me. If worse comes to worse, I'll leave Washington, you can leave California, and we'll set up a farm in Des Moines, Iowa. What difference does it make as long as we're together?
Because being together is not going to solve our problems together, don't you see?
Oh, this is an awful case of deja vu. I remember having the same argument in college, except I was on the other side.
Well, maybe I've matured enough to finally see your point of view.
But it's not necessary anymore. Look, I know I'm not the homemaker type. And I probably would never be a traditional wife. But I'm willing to change a little.
Janet, I don't want you to change. Don't you see that? I don't want you to change. You're a bright, hardworking woman. You're intelligent. You got a lot going for you. That's what I like about you. I don't want you to change that for me.
I didn't say I was going to turn into Harriet Nelson. I just wouldn't be conducting press conferences anymore. Cody, what happened? 2 minutes ago, we were willing to give up everything for each other. Now it's all turned around. What happened?
Do you remember that fight that we had the other day in front of the elevators where we both made fools of ourselves?
Yeah, what about it?
Okay, what did we resolve there?
I don't know. I don't even remember what the fight was about. All I remember is how we made up.
Well, I remember the fight, okay? And we stood there and we defended ourselves to each other about who we are and what we've done and the choices we made, but we didn't resolve a single thing. All we did is we made love, as always.
Better than always.
Janet, look, okay, so based on one great weekend together, we're going to chuck it all away. We're going to give up everything and we're going to drop out together, right? I don't buy that for a minute. Janet, look at us, will you? We're just two adults playing the same tapes we played back in college, don't you see? The love is still there, the passion is still there, but so are all the conflicts, every one of them. You know, we finally agree that what we want to do is be together, and we can't even agree on how.
I always thought that if two people loved each other enough, that they could overcome any obstacle. Are we failures?
No, we're not failures. We're just humans.
I do love you, Cody.
I love you, too.
Why doesn't that make everything all right?
Okay, we got it. One of our aircraft carriers just decoded a message from someone making some kind of a transfer about 20 miles northwest of the Golden Gate Bridge.
International waters.
Hey, Cody. Cody, we found him, man. We're moving in.
I better get to my press conference.
Babylon Division. This division has confirmed the murder of Danny Lee, an undercover operative for the United States government. An agent of China's intelligence network. As of this hour, Mao is still at large.
Nick, Nick, I see something. 1 o'clock.
For this country were involved in a meeting with Mao. Roger Dorquette was killed, and Mark Eastman remains in serious condition in a local hospital. It is unknown at this time how much classified information was forfeited by the agents before they were shot.
Yeah, that's him. It's gotta be.
Now listen, get in the cargo bay, see if you can wing him or something, all right?
Yeah.
A majority of the discovery that Mao Fei was operating as an imposter is attributed to Nick Ryder, Cody Allen, and Murray Buzinski, who are private investigators from King Harbor, California.
Spelling, please.
Nick Ryder. N-I-C-K-R-Y-D-E-R.
Second name, Allen?
Cody Allen. C-O-D-Y A-L-L-E-N.
Nick, he's holding a gun on somebody. Get the meanie steady. Maybe I can catch him in the shoulder.
All right, hang on. I'm going to try to throw him off balance.
This isn't going to work. Bring the meanie closer. I'm going out.
All right, you got it. Here we go. This is Sikorsky 6908. We've got our man.
Janet, we got him. We got Mao. Actually, it was the Allen guy. Cody Allen, your friend. He got him. He's quite a guy.
Yes. Yes, he is.
That must end. See the rivers rise and fall. They will rise and fall again. Everything must die again. Like an ocean to a shore, like a river to a stream. like a river to a stream. It's the famous final scene. And how you tried to make it work. Did you really think it could? How you tried to make it last? Did you really think it would? Like a guest who stayed too long. Now it's finally time to leave. Yes, it's finally time to leave. Take it calmly and serene. It's the famous final scene. It's been coming on so long. You were just the last to know. It's been a long from the screen. From the famous final scene. Thank you.